People who donate a lot of money to streamers, what's your job? Why are you so generous? A little late to the party, but I like donating to those need money for school / art supplies / game dev. Donate and I'll draw what you want art streams. I go after the ones who have work ethic and ability but lack a large fan base. What I like to do is anonymously donate X to their commission rate or outright buy their needed thing for them on stream, and make my request something easy like drawing their favorite character. It makes my week seeing the reactions. I do it because I was once dreamt about succeeding in the game industry as an artist, but had money barriers. I ground out a ton of work, succeeded, and now make good money in AAA, so now I get to help out others. - Edit: absolutely did not expect the response. Thanks, you guys. I slowly get through some questions after work. No plugs, just support and encourage your favorite creatives if you can. Edit 2: where do I find art streams? I like Picato and Twitch, and Twitter and Tumblr for updates about upcoming streams. Where do I start if I want to work in games? Work on your skills and never stop, whether it's 3D, 2D, animation, code, anything, and participate in game jams. Io, what are the top skills I need to work in games, outside of portfolio? Teamwork, compassion, work ethic. Donate a day, relatively, for me, large amount of money to Philosophy Tube. He was doing a stream of all 30-something of Shakespeare's plays, and the proceeds went to the Samaritans. Felt like the right thing to do. Also, he'd just gotten to what, you egg? And I wanted to be able to put that as my donation comment. I lobbied for and started our Twitch sponsorship program at the company I work at. NBSP. It's absurd how much companies, all of them, us included, pay for digital ad space on Facebook, Google Display, YouTube / Twitch commercials, etc. Meanwhile, streamers have a ton of viewers, sincere engagement, and a majority get paid a pittance. I think old people that manage marketing budgets just haven't caught up. And NBSP, really, what's more impactful? A 30-second ad that everyone ignores or ad blocks, or seeing your favorite streamer wearing and using the same headphones every single day for 8 hours a day? And NBSP, I also pop in on our sponsored streamers every few days, and instead of a direct cash donation, I drop sub bombs of gifted subs. 20 to 50 subs is an enormous gift in any channel, and realistically only costs $100, $250. This directly puts money into the streamer's pockets, but the community also directly benefits on a personal level. It also incentivizes the gifted subbers to resub, creating a recurring cash flow for the streamer. Lastly, it gives the streamer a natural way to do a shout out for the company without being an obvious sellout shill. So to me, it's win-win-win-win. And NBSP, I love the streaming community and it makes me tingly that I can support the community while being pretty effective at my job. I work financial operations for a large university. It's a six-figure job and I have a low cost of living. I do, however, have a crazy amount of fun with tabletop games, card games, and video games. Donating money, more through Patreon and Kickstarters but to streamers as well, is a way for me to both indulge my own likes / hobby and contribute to projects that I believe in. I don't see it as charity or even really generosity. I just love to see people create, and in fact it's a bit selfish as I support these people in hopes that one will create the next big thing for me to enjoy. I've pulled back hard on donating because I moved and have more expenses now than when I was at the height of donating to a streamer. Tushi holds the longest daily stream record, because he did it full time and his entire income was based off of sponsor stuff and the stream supporting him. I was working part time in college at the library when I would donate as much as I could because we're so close in age, and while I knew I would never make it big like him, I wanted to see him still keep going. He also had incentives of having a ping pong ball machine shoot him in the face and playing any songs of our requests on Sundays, and I had, have, I'd kids been a while, a really close friend community that grew from there, so we'd request songs to troll each other, and he's a good sport. Just want to make a small streamer's day. I was watching some kid, probably about 14 or so, but actually very professional and level-headed even when he lost, probably had 25 or so watchers, who had an idiot in the chat who kept telling him that he would give him 20 bucks if he won the game. I think he was playing Fortnite, don't judge me, I was bored. Well, the kid won the game and the guy in the chat said that he wasn't going to give him the money and kept making fun of him for believing him, when in reality the kid had never believed that he was going to give him the money. So I gave the kid $50 and in the donation comment I just made fun of the other guy and said he was a poser and he was broke and he only wished he had enough money to do that. Idiot dude left the chat without saying anything. Look on the kid's face was hilarious. Probably made his whole week. Edit. Wow, this blew up. I don't remember the streamer's name, sorry. At the time I was unable to do my normal shtick of kill time activities, so I was randomly watching a ton of different streamers. Also, thanks for the awards. I give money to Curse Jessect and Crash Course because they deserve it, and I believe education is the key to a better society, and because I know without viewers like me, their videos wouldn't be possible. I'm actually poor, I just want attention. Just fill back up then. I went through a dark time not long ago, and during that time I was tuned into two specific streamers who to me were my salvation. They got me through the time with their content and just genuine fun they were having with the community they had built. So I donated a good bit of money to each because it felt right that I paid them back for the content they gave me. I still donate to streamers today, those who give out good content, because I pay for Netflix, Amazon Prime, etc. Why shouldn't I pay for content that some streamers given the subscription on Twitch is not a lot, so I pay more on the donations. My friend donates obscene amounts of cash to streamers. His logic is that if people stop donating, the streamers will stop playing and he loves them too much. He doesn't have a job, and uses his parents' money, who are very rich and don't care what he spends on, as long as he doesn't bother them. So yeah, you can see right there where this desperation for attention comes from. Oh wow, what strange parenting. When my friend was a cam girl, a lot of her regulars were oil field guys. One of them gave her some money just cause I was on screen and said hi one time. I'm not amazingly attractive or anything and was fully clothed. There was just another girl and it pleased him. Really gave me insight as to how oil field guys can be destitute every time the oil fields slow down, even though they were making bank otherwise. I made so much money in the oil fields. 3k plus after taxes a week with no real housing costs, it was awesome. I wasted it all the time without even thinking because I knew I had way more coming. Not on cam girls slash streamers though, lol. I wouldn't consider it donating, but I guess you might. I purchased VIP for my YouTuber's Minecraft server. No benefits. Doesn't change the game for me at all, like every other goddamn Minecraft server where you need VIP to play. I just brought it so it could help him keep the server alive. It's not much, but I do what I can to help him out whenever. I speak to him regularly on his Discord. Smile, nice bloke. Almost 100k subs. Woo. I have a few streamers who I donate monthly to. I only teach for a living, but I get a housing subsidy and live in a place with a really low cost of living. When my father died, I donated a lot of money from my inheritance to Etika and Northern Leon. They are the two streamers who gave me the most laughs and comfort in a time where I needed anything at all to distract me from my loss. Etika had his first big breakdown maybe 4 or 5 months after that, but I like to think my donation helped provide some sort of comfort in the time leading up to his decline. I donated to one streamer who helped me ease up a bit during studying for my MCAT, which is the entrance exam for medical schools here in the US. Dude was hilarious, was a raging alcoholic, and would just generally suck at video games. Way I see it, some streamers provide hours of entertainment. I pay to watch a movie in theaters for 10 bucks. Paying to support a streamer who provided weeks of entertainment is similar to me. I donated $100 to Nick Merckx and he plugged my business. Had about a 30% increase of sales that week, so I profited. Edit, my first gold. Thank you, anonymous friend. Edit, some of you are really mean. I'm new to Reddit and dang, didn't expect some people to be so nasty. Love the rest of you though, and LT3. What counts as a lot? I did a couple hundred dollars last year, which felt like a lot, but honestly it still came out cheaper than a year of cable TV bills, which I cancelled, and I enjoyed the content way more. Just figured if I spend dozens or hundreds of hours watching someone I should support. I watch in the background a lot while working, so I feel I get my money worth. I'm sure that I'm still a small fish in the donation bucket. Not me, but I know a lawyer who is a huge nerd, and he said his accountant is giving him shit for spending over $35,000 last year on Twitch donations. His reasoning is, I get drunk and then think it's funny to watch people go apeshit on stream when I drop a big donation. I then not so subtly mentioned that I can turn a stream whenever you feel like getting drunk again, lol. I dunno, maybe it's Bill Gates in disguise. The Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation donated like $1 million to a charity PewDiePie stream. It was cringemas BTW. I haven't donated that much, but they're streaming to entertain people and make money. If I'm watching and being entertained, I'm more than happy to chuck them a donation here and there to support it. I've donated at least $1,000 to a streamer named VodGoblin over the course of a few years. I have the Gold Bit badge, gifted over 50 subs, and donated countless memes. And hashtag X200B, up until April this year I was just a servant at a football stadium. I made $9.50 an hour. But I like to give away money. It makes me feel good to help others, especially people I find entertaining, and friendly, and hardworking. If I can help someone achieve their dream job, but supporting the stream, I'm happy to. Unfortunately the guy never got going enough to get partnered, and hasn't streamed much lately. But certainly not for my lack of trying. Username. I don't know what you call a lot of money, but I have donated about $10,000 in the year of 2016. This was divided over a number of donations to various streamers. I would usually look for guys who were new and were putting in effort into their stream, fostering a fun environment and having likable personalities. Usually if they had some goals, like they wanted to buy some item and were raising funds for it, I would just donate towards that. This doesn't include all the CSGO skins and knives I donated. Probably upwards of $5,000. My job? I run my own business, and $10,000 over a year is no big deal. Write it off as a business expense. Make your username your business name like some other dude in this post. I know someone who went 20k plus in debt in Twitch donos. He has a really high paying job in commercial server moderation. I am a small time streamer and an IT help desk worker. I have donated over $3,000 to Fire Dragon because during my father's diagnosis of pancreatic cancer and his death, Fire Dragon's videos and streams were pretty much the only things that kept me smiling and gave me the inspiration to push forward in college and pursuing streaming. If I could give him more, I would, without any hesitation. He is a wonderful streamer and human being and strives to give people a good community and place to just relax and let it all go for a little bit. I'm what's called a heading technician. Basically I run and maintain 15 machines that turn 900 plus kilogram, 1900 plus pounds. Spools of wire into the bolts that hold your cars and trucks together. I work in the US, but we use the metric system for everything at work. Anyhow, I make a lot of money because there's probably 100 people in the US that know how to run all the machines I do. Because of that, I make a really good living. I love video games, and have since I was a kid. I'm 36 and just don't have time to play much anymore because of real world things. Absolutely love dropping in a low sub count stream on Twitch and watching them play. If I find them to be a solid player in the game I choose, or they suck at the game but they're having a blast playing and interacting with their commenters, I'll drop $50 to $100 on their stream.